The intelligence we got last year was that churches in Sulu, Basila, and Atsambuanga will be bombed. So that's why the church, since August of last year, has been the church that was bombed in Sulu, was guarded by soldiers 24 hours a day. And for some reason, the bombers were still able to cut inside the church, exploded it. About 1.5 minutes later, when the people were rushing out, another bomb exploded in front. The second one appears to be a suicidal one because there's some body parts is thrown all over this person. Half the face was blown off. The investigators found 2 feet, but you cannot identify him, so nobody's claiming him. So we are still trying to find out who this guy is. The first one maybe is not a suicide bomb because there was this survivor who was sitting 4 seats behind a woman. She saw this lady sat there, then left, leaving behind a package. We are accusing them because they are the ones that have been roaming around armed and doing trouble there in Sulu. We do not know if the foreigners carried out the attack. But there is no history yet that a Filipino conducted a suicide attack. I can only maybe say that the second bomb was a suicide bomber because somebody died. But then again, we are not sure if he really is a suicide bomber. Maybe he was just carrying the bomb and somebody triggered it. Because the soldiers were very strict. They inspect all the people getting into the church since several months back. So that's a puzzle to us because maybe the soldiers got lax in inspecting those who are getting into the church. You know, because churchgoers, you don't expect them to do mayhem inside. We believe that because Sawadjan, there are 2 groups of Abu Sayyaf in Hulu, Radulan, Sahiron, and Sawadjan. Sawadjan actually is pledged loyalty to the ISIS in the Middle East. And he claims to be the caliph in that part of the area. So maybe he attracts foreign fighters because of his allegiance to the ISIS. And he's the only group. This is the only group that has reported to be harboring foreign fighters. So maybe they are they planned it, getting orders from somewhere else. But we still believe that these are local terrorists that are doing trouble there. That's possible. In fact, some of the fighters coming from Indonesia and Malaysia who went to Syria, who came back, may have also came to the Philippines. Not the whole lot, but a small group. According to our intelligence, we suspect there are about 40 there, spread all over Mindanao, some in central Mindanao, some in Basilan, some in Sulu. But the presence of a few of those roaming around is still very alarming. Some people said they're from Morocco, from Yemen, also from Pakistan. We haven't seen any Syrians or Iraqis there, but some Asians. That's it, about three nationalities. But during the Malawi siege, surprisingly, there is one guy from Chichnya that was also killed there. So yeah, sounds like the people there are attracting a lot of bad guys coming inside. Yeah.